comic Valentine. You make me smile within my heart. Oh, yeah. Your looks are unphotographable, yet you're my favorite work of art. Oh, is your figure a little less than Greek? Yeah. If you care for me, yeah, stay my little Valentine, stay. Cause each day thank you.
Thank you. that on? Yes. Hi there. Thank you. Yes, this is my natural speaking voice. I get my room service a lot faster. Mr. Briggs. How's everybody? Well, I'm glad to see you. Glad to see you. It's been quite a whirlwind month for me. A little crazy, unusually crazy, because I think, let's see, I went to Cuba this month. I was in Jamaica day before yesterday. I was in Charlottesville last week, Birmingham, and some other places I can't think of. And now I'm here in Elizabeth City, just a couple hours away from where I grew up. I didn't hear all the bio stuff, I don't know, but I will tell you this. I learned to play in the public school system in Portsmouth, Virginia. Yes. And it saddens me when I think of how music has been pulled out of schools, because this saved my life. And it's like, are you married? I'm like, yeah, his name is Marvin. A little temperamental sometimes. Back in 2018, bought me a brand new car. He helped me raise my kids. Mm-hmm. Yeah, all right. Considering there looks like a storm brewing out there, and that's all right. We're going to make a storm right here, and we're going to beat that storm. Let's have a hand for this wonderful rhythm section. Yes. This is Mr. Dennis Figgs. I spoke to him before I came here, and at first it was just going to be he and I. Well, before that, it was just going to be me and some tracks. And then it became you and I. And then he's like, do you want a band? And I was like, you can get a band? He said, yeah. And he got a band. And I met them today, this afternoon. And this for them was like cramming for a final. I can tell you that I didn't mean to do it, but that was just the way it worked out. But we have professional musicians here, and they did the trick. And they're here tonight to entertain you and to have fun with me, right? So I'm going to have you, Mr. Dennis, introduce the other members of this phenomenal rhythm section.
Mr. Ellert Forster on drums. And of course, Jeremy Ward on bass. Yeah, we've been working together for a little while, so we'll see how it goes.
Just a little while, huh? Yes. I always know when I'm at home, because one thing about being down south is that y'all would just wipe an entire syllable out of my name. Now, I know some of you know what I'm talking about. You know my name here is Kern. Not Karen, but Kern. And whenever I hear somebody say, I'm like, you from Virginia, aren't you? You from North Carolina, aren't you? If you're close enough to Virginia, you're going to do that. And that's okay. That's probably what I'm going to name my next album project. Right now, we're going to move along. We're going to play a standard that was first probably heard on Disney, in a Disney movie. And this is our take on Someday, My Prince Will Come.
Thank you.
Why am I too short for the mic? Because I didn't wear heels. Okay. And I can't get the thing to go down. Let me see. I got to work this out. Okay. Second, that's just going to bring it. That helps. Okay. Yeah, these are the things that go on usually behind the scenes. But see, I'm regular about things. So y'all going to see. The mic stand was too tall. Okay, that's better. Oh, yeah. So, as you can tell, I'm really wishing on that Prince very hard. anyhow, we're going to move along now. We're going to do a tune that was made popular by Cyndi Lauper. And I love this song. I've been playing it a long time. I think the first time I ever played it was on the waterfront in Portsmouth. And here I'm playing it again. Slightly different arrangement. This is called Time After Time.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, that was fun. And I'm going to tell you, if it wasn't for the traveling, I would say I never worked a day in my life. But the traveling, man, we need a bullet train in this country because I'm kind of getting tired of that air pressure on my ears and TSA and all that stuff. Nothing personal if you work for them, but, you know, when you go through there about 8-9 times a month for the last 40, 50 years, it's like, we need a bullet train. Yes. I mean, really, because you go to France and China, them trains like 300 miles. I've been to like 48 countries in my life, and they have these trains. They just zip the 300 miles an hour. Boom, you're there. Like, no security checks, no radiation, you know, no ear pressure, none of that. You know, you just sit down. You can relax. You can get up and walk around. We need a bullet train. Yeah. Maybe I should name my project the bullet train. Yeah. Okay. Being silly. Okay. So, I play a lot of the genres of music, picked up a little bit of information from each and every country I've gone to, really. And this one piece by Rimsky-Korsakov called Scheherazade. Anybody familiar with that? Yes. Well, this is my take on that song. And if you guys are interested in some of this music, some of what we're playing is available at my website, which is KarenBriggsViolin.com. That's easy, right? All one word, Karen Briggs Violin. Can I hear y'all say that? Oh, yes, y'all are choir. Yes, and this song is also there, and this is called Scheherazade's Groove. Any belly dancers in the house? No? Okay. Thank you. Thank you, and I hope Mr. Rimsky was not mad about that, and I hope there are no classical purists in here that might be mad about that. That was just how I was feeling about that song at the time. Yeah, okay. So one of the things that I noticed about this band in this short time that we've had to be together today is that we all know a lot of standards, and one of my favorites is called just that, My Favorite Things. Y'all ready? All right.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to say, I know we've all been through a whole lot in these last few years. Any exceptions? It's been a trying time, but it was a good time because I know for me, I had to stop everything like most everybody else and sit down and process my life for a second or two or three. And, you know, it was a time of growth, I think, for a lot of people because you didn't have all those distractions except the one big one. I mean, there's no distractions. You couldn't go anywhere. You couldn't go to work. Couldn't be distracted by doing anything, really, except sit down and dealing with your family, perhaps your children, and your own inner thoughts and processes and get a chance to focus on what you think is best to focus on. Some people probably made some major changes. I know I did because I left Los Angeles. Me and my two girls drove across the country. Took 3 days, and it was a nice distraction. And then we got to Charlotte, and we got in our place, and my sister was there, my niece was there. This is what I didn't have in California for over 30 years, no family. So for me, this was massive, big difference. Everything slowed down. And Charlotte is a pretty major city, but it's still slower than LA. But it's starting to kind of creep that direction because a lot of people came there, and I see the traffic getting kind of like that. I'm going to have to move again. It's nice and peaceful around here, though. Every place I went was within 10 minutes. Every place I've been since I've been here yesterday, it was 5 minutes, 9 minutes, 8 minutes. I was like, I love this. I love it. Anyhow, I want to dedicate this song to you. It's a standard that, you know, I think all of us have been playing it a long time from what we call the fake book. That's kind of the Bible of jazz, if you will, all the songs that we all have to learn. And I'm going to tell y'all something, because y'all heard of Terry Lynn Carrington, the drummer? Anyone? Yeah? Okay, the musicians have heard of her. Well, she teaches at Berkeley up in Boston, the music school there, and she made a startling discovery that I never thought about. This book is like 3 inches thick, and it has no women composers, but we're all required to know this book. So Terry Lynn created another one, like last year. And she called me up, Karen, do you have any songs to submit? I gave her 2 songs, and of course she took the one that had the drum solo. And I believe this is going to be coming out sometime early next year. And so you'll hear some, hopefully, within the years passing, musicians will incorporate this into their vocabulary as well, and you'll hear more music that's written by female composers. That's a plus in light of the big change otherwise. I'm not going to talk about that. You know, music ain't got nothing to do with that. So that's right. Now, I told them in Cuba, too. I'm like, I went to Cuba. Like I told you, I went to Havana. I played with the National Symphony Orchestra and at the National Theater there. Quite an event. Amazing musicianship there. And when I came back and told people how beautiful the experience was, of course, there were some expats. Why'd you go to Cuba? Cuba is problematic. It's a dictatorship. Music has nothing to do with that. I just played a song by a Russian composer. It's a beautiful piece. Music has nothing to do with that. Okay? Just want to keep it straight. All right. So this song is for you. Hey, wait a minute, before we get there, anybody celebrating anything? Birthday, anniversary, grandbaby, divorce? Anybody? No? No celebrations? Birthday! It's your birthday! July 4th. Well, I won't be here, so I guess we have to celebrate a little early. Yes. Okay, well, this is just for you. It's called All the Things You Are. Thank you. Man, that was fun. I can tell you, I haven't played jazz like this in quite a while, actually. I've been playing a lot of pop music, a lot of my original stuff, some of which you heard a little bit of my arrangements tonight. And because I'm working on another project to be coming out sometime, probably in 2023. Just be on the lookout for that. What's the website? Y'all remember? Oh, y'all are good. Real good. Well, I just want to tell you, I've been here a couple of days. I went to school today and talked to some kids. That was wonderful. They had great questions. I said, y'all should be publicists. They ask better questions than some of the pros out there. And I did also a concert last night without live musicians to some tracks. So they got to hear a lot of my new material. Nice sneak preview. And I prefer, of course, playing with live musicians. No question about that. It's a lot more fun. I hope that our energy and our synergy is translating over to you as well. But I have to tell you, there have been some times when I've played some other genres, and I used to be connected with a record label called Hidden Beach. And Hidden Beach did like about 8 volumes of this project called Unwrapped. What is Unwrapped? They took the rapper off and replaced it with improvising jazz musicians. So they gave me this song that was originally by Stevie Wonder called Pastime Paradise. And then this guy with weird hair named Coolio got a hold of it, and it became Gangsta's Paradise somehow. And they asked me to play it and took Coolio and all the rappers off. So now it's Karen's Paradise. No, it's really still called Gangsta. That's just, it's not gangster, it's gangsta. Just an A at the end. Apostrophe S, gangsters. And I'm not advocating anything here. I just want you to know, I just play music, ain't got nothing to do with that. But I think it's a grand finale for every show I've ever done under my own name. And, you know, you may see me playing with other groups like Special Effects with Kielly Minucci, with Loudtizer, Jazz in Pink, Havley with Stanley Clark. You might see me on the road with Diana Ross every now and again. I'll play and tour with her for a while. And, but what we're working on is Karen Briggs touring like what I'm doing now. Yes. Like to thank Valencia for making all the arrangements and having me here. It was just wonderful. You guys are wonderful. You look amazing. You smell good. You just feel good. And I'm grateful to be here and grateful for all of you that did come. Should have been more people, but I play the same way for 20,000 people as I do for 20 or less. That's the purpose. Any questions? Any questions? Okay, fine. Y'all ready? Start the pulse, baby. Thank you.
Price, Mr. Jeffrey Whalen, the Chair of Music and Visual Arts, who also created the program design. Thank you so much, and thank you for being here. To Ms. Melville Smith and Rhonda Hayes, the local radio and marketing team, and to Mr. Seth Luton on the sound, and Mr. Dennis Figgs in the Baddest Rhythm Section in Elizabeth City. So thank you so much. So for those of you who are interested in having your children take violin lessons, please see Mr. Danny Tate. Danny, if you raise your hand, or myself. The lessons are free, as well as the instruments are free. So take advantage of this opportunity. Thank you so much, and you are dismissed.
Popping all y'all because y'all was acting up.